It may not be much, but it would be nonetheless more money in your pocket. House Republicans want to take some of the $300 million in extra money from the state and speed up a planned $90 million individual income tax cut. Lindsey Vermes on how much of it you'd see.
Every little bit helps. That's what Michigan Republicans are saying about an individual tax relief plan they launched Tuesday.
This is money that belongs to the taxpayers, so we are doing the right thing by giving some money back to the hardworking taxpayers of the state of Michigan.
Republicans say the state budget is in better shape than anyone anticipated, and they have a responsibility to take that money and put it back in the wallets of taxpayers. Under the plan, the personal income tax rate would drop from 4.35% to 4.25%. Then there's the personal exemption. It would bump up from $3,700 to more than $3,900. The move comes after criticism from Democrats that Republican tax breaks have focused on business only and left middle-class families struggling. Republicans say they're doing what they can to boost Michigan's economy. Now that it is in an upswing, they say the state should give back.
When I do my budget, every little bit helps, and I would be very appreciative to get anything back.
The nonprofit Michigan League for Human Services is opposed to the new plan. It feels the money could do more if it stays with the state.
It's being touted as, oh, we're going to go and save everybody money. We're reducing taxes, but that's really not exactly true. You got to kind of dig through the weeds.
With an October start date, the league says the tax cut for a middle-class person making $66,000 a year is just $22.
Sort of interesting if you take a look at, you know, the timing of all of this.
Republicans argue even in small amounts, this money belongs to the taxpayers. In Lansing, Lindsey Vermes, Fox 47 News.
The rates would take effect in October if passed. Republican leaders say the caucus is working on additional plans for individual tax relief. Governor Snyder wants the budget finalized by June 1st.